Capital District Off Track Betting.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses. 18 races to bring you, 10 different stops, though. Boy, winter time, not as quiet as years past. A terrific weekend of racing, East Coast, West Coast. We're going to start off on the West Coast of Florida. Down at Tampa Bay Downs, one of their two or three biggest days of the year. Up first, the Suncoast Stakes.
And they're off and running in the Suncoast. Our Angel Caitlin up on the outside breaks for the lead. There goes Tappa, 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 moving up now and emerging with the lead. Belted is there toward the rail, and Living a Dream is the last horse away as they swing around the clubhouse turn. Tappa, Tappa, Tappa with blinkers on, now going on with it and has the lead by a length. Belted is there toward the rail second. There's the favorite Elate moving up on the outside now to be third. Our Angel Caitlin, in search of three wins in a row, settles back now to be fourth. Living a Dream on the outside is fifth. The length and a half farther back, Venus Arena sixth, and far, far back is Racing Embrace as they settle for their journey up the backstretch. Tappa, Tappa, Tappa dashes clear now to lead the race by four with Belted second. From the outside, Elate racing along third. Our Angel Caitlin moves to the inside and now putting in a run fourth. Then it's 2.5 lengths farther back to Venus Serena now fifth as they swing around the far turn. Tappa, Tappa, Tappa and Castanon, they've been uncontested up front. They're still the leaders, and now Elate gets the wake-up call on the outside and going after the leader second. Our Angel Caitlin is gained down along the inner rail, but she's under an all-out ride with a quarter of a mile to run. Tappa, 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 and Castanon still sitting chilly. On the outside, Elate and Ortiz goes to work on the heavy favorite as they straighten away for the run to the wire. It's Tappa, Tappa, Tappa in front. Elate on the outside, continuing to grind away. Our Angel Caitlin is third, but inside the final furlong, it's Tappa, Tappa, Tappa at 9-1, and she will pull the upset. Handled beautifully throughout by Castanon. We'll take it by three. Elate was second. Our Angel Caitlin was third. Venus Serena was fourth. And running time on the board, 139.91.
And as Dave Grenning tweeted on Twitter, Bill Mott said Elate wasn't absolutely at her best at a 3-10. I think the fans might have wanted to know that. But Tappa, Tappa, Tappa goes to the front. Elate tries to make the overland run. Doesn't get it done. The offspring of Tappet wins by three, returns a hefty $21.40. The 3-10 favorite finishes second. Our Angel Caitlin finishes third. Over to the turf for the Tampa Bay.
And they're off in the Grade 3 Tampa Bay Stakes all away in good order. Kasicki breaks for the lead toward the rail. Inspector Lindley now moves up. And there goes Turbo Street now emerging and going to the early lead. Irish Strait is away with a top flight from the outside, Kai Gun, and the last horse away is Coco Mon. A very compact field as they pass under us for the first time. Toward the rail is Turbo Street. Up on the outside, Irish Strait is right there second. Catapult will go to the turn three wide, racing along third. Inspector Lindley is down along the inner rail now with a ground-saving trip fourth. Way out on the outside, Coco Mon now moves up to be fifth. It's a length and a half farther back. It's Not Easy Being Breezy is down along the inner rail as they settle for their journey up the backstretch. Turbo Street, the leader now by a half a length. Irish Strait draws alongside to challenge second. Catapult on the outside third. Inspector Lindley is down along the inner rail now, racing along fourth. Bondurant is right there between horses fifth. Coco Man on the outside sixth. Kasicki is down along the inner rail. Will need racing room. Seventh. Then we go back to It's Not Easy Breezy. Now racing along eighth as they swing around the far turn. It's Turbo Street still with the lead. Catapult is moving up on the outside now to challenge. Irish Strait is still right there. Then it's 2.5 lengths farther back. Bondurant down along the inner rail. Inspector Lindley awaits racing room. And now Kasicki Alvarado gives him the wake-up call. But meanwhile up front, 3/16 of a mile still to run. It's Irish Strait trying to pull the upset. Irish Strait is still there and up on the outside, charging his Inspector Lindley. And toward the rail is Turbo Street. Here comes Inspector Lindley charging. And on the outside, Kasicki absolutely flying. Inspector Lindley will get up and take it from a fast closing. Kasicki on the outside with Irish Strait fading to be third.
Inspector Lindley from the inside post position. John Blasquez aboard the offspring 11 Job Crit. trained by Shug McGahey. They score by half a length, returning $9.60. Cassie Key finishes second. Irish Trade finishes third. Catapult, the 5-2 favorite, finishes fourth in the Tampa Bay. Three-year-olds on the road to the Kentucky Derby kicked off in the Sam Davis.
And they're off and running in the 37th running of the Sam Davis. Chance of Luck breaks for the lead. State of Honor moves through toward the rail. Up between horses, that's Fact Finding. Up on the outside, Wild Shot now moves up and takes over fourth. And already far back is Long Shot, Six Gun Salute. As they swing around the clubhouse turn, that State of Honor now going on with it, and he has the lead by two. Toward the rail, Fact Finding now moves up second. Locally based Chance of Luck is up on the outside third, three parts of a length. Taprit is tucked in toward the rail fourth. Wild Shot on the outside, now racing along fifth. From between horses, No Dozing is there sixth. Then it's 2.5 lengths farther back to McCracken, and then it's a big break of 5 lengths back. Six Gun Salute is the trailer. They continue their journey up the backstretch at 11-1. State of Honor trying to take them start to finish has the lead by a length. Fact Finding is second. Chance of Luck from the outside is third. Taprit is now being shoved on fourth. From the outside, Wild Shot now putting in a run fifth. 2.5 lengths farther back to No Dozing now sixth. Then it's a break of 3 lengths farther back. McCracken, and now Hernandez gets busy on McCracken as they approach the quarter mile pole. It's still State of Honor and Julian Laperrue controlling the pace. Wild Shot on the outside second. Taprit is toward the rail third, and there he goes, McCracken on the outside. He swings to the center of the racetrack, and Hernandez has him in full stride as they're into the stretch. Wild Shot strikes to the lead. McCracken on the outside gaining with every stride, and now collars the leader. Here's McCracken on the outside. Hernandez goes to the left-handed whip, drifts in slightly, but McCracken remains unblemished and will take the Sam Davis. Taprit is flying on for second. State of Honor is there for third, and Wild Shot finished fourth, and the running time on the board, 142.45.
McCracken, on the top of many people's list for the Derby, makes the first start of the year, first start away from Churchill Downs. He takes the overland route successfully under Brian Hernandez. The 3-2 favorite, the offspring of Ghost Zapper, returns $5 even. Taprit finishes second. State of Honor finishes third. And finally on Saturday afternoon, back to the turf. This time the Distaffers in the Endeavor.
And they're off. Isabella Sings breaks for the lead. Light in Paris is there toward the rail. Cactus Copy comes away from between horses. Third, Emerald Pond is the last horse away as they pass under the wire for the first time. As expected, the speedy Isabella Sings now going on with it, and she bumps the margin to three. Cactus Copy is there second toward the rail. Light in Paris racing along third. Then it's a break of three to Azalea now racing along fourth. Down along the inner rail is Emerald Pond fifth. Lots of Lex. 5 lengths farther back to Evidently, as they settle for the run up the backstretch. The speedy Isabella Sings moves clear now to command the race by 7. Light in Paris keeps her in sight second. Then it's a break of 3. Cactus Copy racing along third. Emerald Pond is now fourth. Azalea is shaken up for run fifth. As they leave the half-mile marker, it's Isabella Sings still on a long lead. Light in Paris racing along second. Azalea is there third. 4 lengths farther back to Lots of Lex now fourth. As they approach the quarter mile pole, as always, Isabella Sings, she's up front and she's the target to run down. Light in Paris is set down for the drive now to be second. They swing for home. Isabella Sings rushing along beautifully up front. Light in Paris and Centeno sets her down for the drive, and she's in full stride and gaining on the leader. Down to the wire, it's Isabella Sings finding more. Light in Paris continues to grind away second, but Isabella Sings will make every pole a winning one in a game effort. Light in Paris settles for second. Running time on the board, 141.07.
And Isabella Sings, no tepping in here. She wins under John Velasquez. The 1-2 favorite wins by 3 lengths, returning $3 even. Light in Paris finishes second. Evidently finishes third. We'll take a quick break when we come back the other side of the state of Florida and the fairgrounds.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off Exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
Hey, we've got a new show.
We do.
Absolutely, And They're Off, right here on the OTB TV network Sunday mornings.
What's it all about?
It'll be a lot of fun. Fast-paced, plenty of topics, guests, handicapping, commentary, and maybe some opinions.
I have opinions on my opinions.
And we will have plenty of them because you're on the show. And They're Off, Sunday mornings here on the OTB TV network, 10 a.m. each Sunday. Should be a lot of fun. Anthony Mormino, Seth Merrill, we'll see you there.
I'm sorry, I went...
In a recent study of some of the top online wagering sites, Capital OTB won big in total player rewards, far surpassing some of the best-known wagering sites in America. While other rewards programs simply offer you points redeemable for gift cards, Capital OTB's rebates are paid to you in actual cash. Plus, Capital OTB gives you full and immediate access to your money. So if all you're getting now are points and gift cards, join Capital OTB Player Rewards today and get cash back. Visit CapitalOTBBet.com and sign up today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Continuing with the theme of distaffers on the turf in the state of Florida. But now we head over to Gulfstream Park for three stakes races on Saturday afternoon. Up first, the Suwannee River.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Suwannee River. Good start inside for Sharp Kitty. From the outside, Dickinson is showing speed. Here's Cali 37 marching between horses. And Joe Bravo puts Cali 37 on the lead as they run past the finish line the first time. Sharp Kitty reined back by Trujillo to race in second. From the outside, Goldie Esponi will be a bit wide while racing third. Dickinson is now fourth. Seacoast at the rail fifth. Then comes Sandiva from sixth. A length better than My Sweet Girl seventh. Alicia's World is eighth. And trailing the field is Puka. Around the first turn they go, they went 23 and 2 for the opening quarter speed. It's Cali 37 in front by a length and a half. Goldie Esponi is second, Sharp Kitty is third. Dickinson is on hold fourth, Seacoast rides the rail fifth. Then Sandiva, a length back to the outside, My Sweet Girl, followed by Alicia's World, and trailing is Puka. The opening half mile was covered in 47 and 1. There's been no change in the plot. Cali 37 has the lead. Goldie Esponi stalks from second, Sharp Kitty third. On hold fourth is Dickinson. Here's Sandiva to be forced to make a move as trying to get her spot was My Sweet Girl. And now Sandiva's into fourth and moving up. Down at the rail, Seacoast gets the shuffled. Alicia's World will need a way through. Close enough if good enough. And Puka's last. Any one of them in with the chance here after three quarters in 110 and 3. Cali 37 yet to be run down. She leads by a length. Whip is out on Goldie Esponi. Sandiva's working hard but gaining ground from third. From the back, here's Alicia's World swung into action and gaining good ground as they turn for home. Cali 37's led the whole way. Over the top is Alicia's World. Sandiva's next. Dickinson tries to thread the needle up the inside. Here's Dickinson getting through on the rail inside the 16th pole. And Dickinson and Paco Lopez ride the rail to win. Alicia's World second. Sandiva third. Close for fourth between Puka and Cali 37 in 145-1.
Dickinson, Paco Lopez, Karen McLaughlin, Godolphin Stable. They score by a length and a quarter. The offspring of Medallia Dior returns $11.40. Elsie's World finishes second. The 3-2 favorite, Sandiva, finishes third in the Suwannee River. Now, grade one action on the turf, this time also a mile and a half. The girls went a mile and an eighth on a different configuration. Then next up, the grade one Gulfstream Park turf handicap.
And they're off in the Gulfstream Park turf handicap. From the center, Beach Patrol was away well. Down on the inside, Luke's Alley is showing speed. At the rail, War Correspondent comes away in the top flight. These three are quickest. Edgar Prado trying to find a spot for Divisadero. Moving up on his outside is Herrig. And here's Herrig, offensive-minded, all the way up to challenge Beach Patrol for the lead. From behind the speed, flatlined, and on his inside, Almanar. All included is eighth and last as they run into the first turn. Florent Giroux and Beach Patrol cut the corner with a narrow lead. On his outside is Herrig second. War Correspondent is third. Luke's Alley between horses is now fourth. Then it's the grade one winner, three wide fifth for Divisadero. Stretch of two to Almanar. Flatlined is next, and all included is last of all for the opening quarter in a spirited 23-2. Down the back stretch they go. Beach Patrol has the lead, trying to back it down, but no breathers as Eric is alongside second. At the rail, War Correspondent follows a joint third alongside Divisadero. Luke Sally is parked between horses for Luis Saez, working a length better than an inside running Almanar. At the back, all included, and has his outside is flatlined through a 47-set half mile. Less than half a mile to go now on the 31st running, the Gulfstream Park Turf Handicap. And up top, it's Beach Patrol in front by a neck. Three wide, here's Divisadero on the attack for Prado. Working between horses is Eric. Gaffleone's got his hands full with War Correspondent. Off cover, Almanar. That'll send flatlined into the five path. All included tries to pick a path. All eight of them in with a chance here. Three quarters, 1-10-1. Off cover, War Correspondent gets the garden trip and he's up for a short lead. Beach Patrol fights on, but they both have to look out for Almanar, who's in the center of the course for Joel Rosario, and Almanar surges to win. Almanar three parts of a length in the end. I think Beach Patrol fought on for second. All included got running, then War Correspondent in 1:45-3.
Well, folks, first off, we have a disqualification there. Beach Patrol disqualified from second for interference in the stretch. Lugging out, disqualified in place fourth. The final running time you'll see is 1/5 of a second slower than the girls went in the Suwannee River just the race before. But I will note, different turf courses. And timing of races has been big of late, so take that into consideration. Joel Rosario, very strong in the stretch. Almanar scores the victory for Chad Brown, returns $8 even. All included at 15-1, elevated to second. And the second longest shot in the war board, War Correspondent, elevated to third. The 2-1 favorite, Divisadero, finishes sixth. Up next on the dirt, the one-turn mile, the grade two, the Gulfstream Park Handicap.
And they're off in the Gulfstream Park Handicap. Good start out wide for Awesome Banner, who heads off for the year lead. Sharp Azteca is not far away. Tommy Macho from down toward the rail. Blofeld between horses. As they run out of the one-mile chute, Sharp Azteca and Blofeld go on with Tommy Macho and Awesome Banner third and fourth. Zulu is between horses in fifth, followed by Longshot High Riverside. The two at the back are Awesome Slough and the stretch runner, Squadron A. Less than 6 furlongs to go. The opening quarter was just 23-3. Not that fast for this caliber of competition. And up front, Blofeld has a head in front. Sharp Azteca right to his outside. Awesome Banner flanks the leaders while third. Tommy Macho between horses as High Riverside scooted up the inside. Zulu has lost a couple spots. He's now third last, second last, and while between horses is Awesome Slough, and trailing the field is Squadron A. 46-1 for the opening half mile. They swing around the far turn, and up top, Sharp Aztec has had enough of Blofeld, moves away by a length. Tommy Macho in the two path is now asked to quicken. Three wide is Awesome Banner. Stretch of four to Awesome Slough. He's into fifth now. The rest really doing no running. Zulu is not picked up his feet with a quarter of a mile left to go. Edgar Zayas and Sharp Azteca given the green light for home after three quarters in 1:10 flat. They turn for home in the Gulfstream Park Handicap, and Sharp Azteca is getting away. He's open five now. Tommy Macho can only watch and wonder down the center. Awesome Slough, Awesome Banner between them. Zulu was finally has some late interest, but the winner, a long gone winner, is Sharp Azteca. Sharp in victory, won it by four. Awesome Slough second, Tommy Macho third, then Awesome Banner and Zulu to complete the high five in 1:34-2.
Sharp Azteca makes it look easy as the second choice in the wager for Jorge Navarro and Edgar Zayas. They win by 4.5 on the line, returning $6 even as the second choice in the wagering. Awesome Sewell, late run to finish second, and the 8-5 favorite, Tommy Macho, finishes third. All right, over to the fairgrounds for their Saturday afternoon stakes action, about 1 mile on the turf. The Broussard Memorial.
And they're off in the Spanky Broussard Memorial. Stallioneros broke sharp. Could not have broken any better for Mitchell Morrill and attains a very easy lead. Does the stakes favorite to Stallioneros, who leads here toward the first turn from Legal Eni, who angled over as they enter the first turn. And then nearest the inside is Brumgo with Hotshot Anna going wide there. Legal Eni was very rank there. Legal Eni rank and did not corner well. Hampered was Hotshot Anna and Picaresque. Legalini, in fact, has been pulled up. Legalini back there pulled up by Miguel Anna as these three-year-old fillies go up the back of the course. 23 4/5 for the first part, and Stallion Eris is the leading lady. Stallion Heiress is well clear here, heading toward the half-mile pole from Brumgo and Super Duper Sky racing a joint second. Hotshot Anna is fourth, and at the inside, Picaresque, last of now a quintet in the running. And it's Stallion Heiress who takes them through a half-mile in 47 and 4/5 seconds. They traverse the far side of the course, 3 furlongs in the winning line. And it's Stallion Heiress who's on a 10-length lead coming toward the quarter pole. Rumgo just second from Super Duper Sky, third at the inside. Hotshot Anna straightens away in fourth, and Picaresque being asked to pick up now by Danny Velasquez. They straighten, 3/4, 1:13, and 2/5 seconds. Stallion Heiress coming down to the final furlong, and Mitchell takes a confident peek back, and Stallion Heiress is rolling through this fairground stretch. Hotshot Anna now gains into the exacta. Rumgo's third, Super Duper Sky. We trail back to Picaresque. It's Stallion Heiress, the exchange rate filly. Stallion Heiress steaming away from them. Hotshot Anna was second, Rumgo third, Super Duper Sky fourth, and Picaresque trailed home.
Stallion Heiress goes to the front from the inside post position at the quarter mile into the race, leading by 9 at the finish, 7 3/4 by the even money favorite, returns $4 even. Hotshot Anna finishes second, Rumgo finishes third. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, stakes action from Turfway, Oaklawn Park, Sam Houston, and Turf Paradise.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week, OTB-TV is the Capital Region's choice for the most comprehensive and informative coverage of thoroughbred and harness racing. OTB-TV is the only area network delivering a steady viewership, reaching more than 540,000 households throughout the broadcast day and into the evening. Capital OTB's digital presence also plays a tremendous part in getting your message in front of potential customers. With more and more wagering moving to online, CapitalOTB.com can put your message in front of thousands of potential customers 24 hours a day. And with the addition of our new mobile app, new customers will see your message on all their digital devices. To see how affordably you can reach thousands of new customers, contact Capital OTB's sales and marketing department today. You're
unbelievable. The championship horse racing continues at Capital OTB. There's no better place to watch, wager, and win than OTB TV and CapitalOTBBet.com.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to Turfway Park, Saturday evening, the Frog Stakes.
And they are off in the Frog Stakes. And Party On Dudes hustled on out. There goes Star Empire is being asked for early speed. Through from between horses, Hunk and Bird and Love is next. Down the inside, Sailing Shoes came away racing close to the pace now, and Enhance the Gray will probe up the fence and in fact take the lead as they straighten up the back stretch. They have 5/8 of a mile still to go. Enhance takes over from My Foolish Bow in second. Sailing Shoes is third. Star Empire races along in the fourth position, out in the clear, only 3.5 lengths off the lead. Hunk of Burning Love is next, a length in front of Stablebane Hey Mike, and outpaced at the back of the pack, Party On Dude is last, 9 lengths off the lead, entrance into the far turn. Enhance shows the way up top for Hanson and Bodie Miller. They're in front by 0.5 length. Star Empire, the big favorite to the outside in second. Sailing Shoes is backpedaling in third. Here comes Hunk of Burning Love, and the Ramsey Silks has moved up into third, is going to switch wide for the drive as they're outside the quarter mile pole. Nobody's got to Enhance. Enhance comes off the turn in front by 2. Star Empire is under a full out drive to hold second. Hunk of Burning Love down the center track in third. They're in the final furlong and Enhance is still up top. Star Empire lunging to the inside. Hunk of Burning Love races up into third. They're in the final 16th. Enhance is drawing away in the EBN. Enhance will give Maker his 5th win in the EBN as Enhance wins by 4. Star Empire was second. Hunk of Burning Love third. Hey Mike was fourth in 1:15 and 4. Just a tick off the track record.
Affectionately known as the Frog, officially the WEBN. Enhance from the inside post position goes to the front for Mike Maker and Abel Lescano. They make all the heading. Win by 3.5, returning $13.20. The 1-2 favorite, Star Empire, finishes second. Hunk of Burning Love finishes third in the WEBN. Over to Oaklawn Park, 3-year-old fillies going a mile in the Martha Washington.
They're off. Chanel's Legacy and Perfect Wife, Lovely Bernadette and Torrent. These are the four quickest. Benner Island and My Sweet Stella, then Ever So Clever. And the early trailer is Queen Bernadette. It's Perfect Wife in the three path at the clubhouse turn, but she's going to cruise to the lead. Perfect Wife now two lengths in front of Chanel's Legacy in second. Lovely Bernadette is tucked in at the rail third with Torrent just outside of her. They're 2.5 or 3 from the front running favorite. My Sweet Stella is fifth, and she's got 5 lengths to make up. Benner Island is 6.5 off the lead. Queen Bernardina is second to last. She's got 8 to make up. And if Ever So Clever wins the 39th, Martha Washington, she'll make up 9 lengths in just over a half mile. And they run midway on the backstretch. And Perfect Wife is the leader. She is now only a half length in front of Chanel's Legacy, who inches closer in second. Torrent is 3 deep with the front runners in her sights. Lovely Bernadette is at the rail. And My Sweet Stella between horses. And on the front end, Chanel's Legacy challenges Perfect Wife. Benner Island is hard ridden, and she's got about 5 to come, about to be joined and passed by Ever So Clever, new leader, far turn, Chanel's Legacy. Perfect Wife is dropping out of it. To the outside end, Torrent, Chanel's Legacy to the short stretch with a half length in front of Torrent in second. My Sweet Stella splits horses, and here's My Sweet Stella. Ever So Clever has 4 lengths to make up. Chanel's Legacy is 2 lengths in front in the short stretch. My Sweet Stella to the outside, Torrent and Ever So Clever, and it is Chanel's Legacy to win the Martha Washington. Chanel's Legacy. Chanel's Legacy won over My Sweet Stella. It is very close for a third between Torrent and Lovely Bernadette.
Chanel's Legacy at 13-1 makes a nice overland route. Scores by 2.5, returning $28.20. Second longest shot on the board at 18-1. My Sweet Stella finishes second. Torrent finishes third. The 8-5 favorite, Perfect Wife, setting the pace, fades to finish last at 8-5. Over to Sam Houston now for the Sam Houston Sprint Cup.
All set. And runners away in the Sam Houston Sprint Cup. And it was a quick start for Brevera from the outside, putting a nose in front early on, racing on his Mimi Joe down along the inside. Ishak is right there with the lead beat as well as they sprint for the far turn. AM Milky Way's in with the lead set as well as several of them converge on the lead here. A span of 2 back to turn up the lights, racing just off the lead beat. Shifarobe at the inside. Mascherato kicks on now, just 6 off the lead from the outside, and there's 2.5 lengths back to the trailer, Flat Black. They've just over a quarter mile to go now in the Sam Houston Sprint Cup, and Union Jackson finds the lead by a length. Ishak is right there at the inside. Mascherato continues to gain. They straighten way down the lane. Union Jackson the one to get with a final furlong. Now opening clear on the field by 3 and by 4. Late save from Mimi Joe once again back on grandstand side, Mascherato, but it's all Union Jackson in the Sam Houston Sprint Cup. Rivera gets in second with Mimi Joe third.
Making it look easy at 3-10, the offspring of Curlin and Hot Dixie Check. They win by 8.25 in Sencio Diego aboard, $2.60. Bravura finishes second. Mimi Joe finishes third at 41-1 in the Sam Houston Sprint Cup. Over to Phoenix, a cloudy day for the Phoenix Gold Cup.
They're off and running in the Phoenix Gold Cup. Beautiful break from all. Ankeny Hill got the jump on the field. Ankeny Hill from, Masterful Stride. Then down along the inside, Alpine Luck and Shrewd Move. Chief Secret Trees Outrun Early is in fifth and is about a length and a half off lead. Caught Wide, another length and a half back to Saturday Night Lights. Then it's Stoney's Mr. Cruiser. Del Rio Harbor is 4 lengths off the lead. Alpine Luck and Shrewd Move are fading away from the front end battle. 2.5 back, and there's O. Newman. Outside of that is Red Solo Cup, not keeping up his alley boss. Through the far turn they go in the Gold Cup. Chief Secret Trees has taken over with 3 furlongs left to go. Chief Secret Trees to his inside, Ankeny Hill. Then dropping out of it, he is because of Masterful Stride. Outside Masterful Stride, Retreat Move trying to come back in Saturday Night Lights and Del Rio Harbor, and they turn for home. Chief Secretaries undefeated, hounded every step of the way by Ankeny Hill. Chief Secretaries in front. Chief Secretaries drifting in a little. Ankeny Hill's going to have to try to get to his outside now inside the final furlong. Saturday Night Lights is digging in. Saturday Night Lights is going to be the new challenge, but Chief Secretaries continues to find more. Chief Secretaries looking to remain undefeated and will in the $75,000 Phoenix Gold Cup. Saturday Night Lights let's next, and then either Ali Boss or Ankeny Hill.
And at Turf Paradise, Chief Secretaries gets the victory as the 9-5 favorite, wins by a length and a half, set the pace from the outside post position, wins by a length and a half. Scott Stevens aboard Saturday Night Lights for second, and Kenny Hill finishes third in the Phoenix Gold Cup. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, stakes action from Golden Gate, Santa Anita, and the Big A.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, and amazing Vegas-style atmosphere, the Clubhouse Racebook, 711 Central Avenue, Albany.
Want more rewards? How about this? During the month of February, all Capital Bets account holders earn an additional 2% cash back on combined wagers of $250 or more when wagering on Aqueduct or Gulfstream Park. Not a Capital Bets account holder? Now's your chance to join and earn an additional 2% cash back on combined exotic wagers. Plus, when you join, wager $50 and Capital OTB will deposit $50 in your account. That's $50 free. No points, no gift cards, actual cash from Capital OTB.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, headed to Northern California for their annual big three-year-old filly stakes race, the California Oaks.
And they're off. Tap began very smoothly, so did Tap It All, who takes the lead. Just behind them, Smiling Ends in third, Shari fourth, four lengths off the early tempo. They're followed by Peaked on the inside of Solana Wynn. Then it's War Moccasin. Simmy's Temple is second to last as they round the first turn. The trailer is She's a Sassy Girl. Tap It All, kept well off the rail by Kyle Frey, just cruising along at a very moderate tempo in front by two lengths. Tapped is chasing her from second. Another three to Shari third, Smiling Ann fourth, Peaked is in fifth. Then comes War Moccasin, racing side by side with Solana Wynn. That pair followed by Simmy's Temple, and She's a Sassy Girl. About 15 lengths covers them five furlongs from home. And it's Tap It All, cruising along with a 2.5 length lead. Tapped is second, the margin widening to six more, back to Shari in third. Then Peaked, racing on the outside of Smiling Ann past the half-mile pole. That pair joined at the rail by War Moccasin. Two more to a hard-ridden Solana Wynn. Then Simmy's Temple, and She's a Sassy Girl. It's been a very easy lead for Tap It All, who's widening at will. 4.5 lengths midway on the far turn. Tapped is under serious pressure in second. At the rails, Smiling Ann is making some progress. Outside of her is Shari. From the back of the pack, Peaked is trying to mount a bid. They're turning for home. Tap It All trying to finish the job. Tapped is within 2.5 lengths of her. Simmy's Temple is cruising into contention third. They're in the final furlong, and Tap It All keeps on going. Very strong past the 16th pole. Shari is rallying outside of Tap. They're battling for second. Tap It All, a convincing winner of the California Oaks. Tapped was second. Shari third. Simmy's Temple fourth.
Tap It All, the offspring of Tapazar, goes to the front, holds on to win by a length and three quarters for Doug O'Neill. The second choice in the wagering returns $12.40. The 2-5 favorite, Tap, for Jerry Hollendorfer, can do no better than second. Shari, at nearly 50-1, finishes third in Saturday's California Oaks. Triumvirate Stakes races to bring you from the great race place. Up first, the Santa Maria.
Vale Dori straightens, racing. Vale Dori, after acting up in the gate, begins on terms with them. Autumn Flower showing some dash with Sheer Pleasure. Midnight Toast along the inside. It's Vale Dori with a share of the lead, three wide presently. Midnight Toast poking along the fence. Autumn Flower was between them, but eases back. At the 7/8 pole, Midnight Toast the leader, Vale Dori stalking. Autumn Flower dropping to the inside third, joined by Sheer Pleasure with two lengths to Lady Tappet and two more to Show Stealer. 3/4 of a mile left to go. Midnight Toast ahead in front of Vale Dori. Favourite drawing level in the run onto the back stretch. Sheer Pleasure is two lengths away. She's going to enjoy a good trip third, striding away from Autumn Flower. Lady Tappet off the rail in fifth, five off the leaders, and Show Stealer at the tail of the field. Midnight Toast is maintaining a slender advantage in the middle stages from Vale Dori, and next separating them as they approach the half-mile marker. Sheer Pleasure third, almost rejoined on her inside by Autumn Flower, then Lady Tappet, and Show Stealer taken to the outside by Bays, about to commence a move, only 3.5 lengths front to back. Vale Dori, the new leader, takes up the running from a very hard-ridden Midnight Toast, coming to the 5/16. Sheer Pleasure under plenty of pressure, moving up second, and Show Stealer from the rear is out wide and running on well, but it's Vale Dori at the quarter pole, a length and a half. Show Stealer's the one to take a run at her as she pulls alongside Sheer Pleasure, then Midnight Toast, Autumn Flower, Lady Tappet, the widest runner. Vale Dori clear into the stretch by 2.5 lengths. She's moving away easily from Show Stealer, who's holding down second in advance of the others, are pretty much in a line, but Vale Dory's in front. In second position is Show Stealer, but Vale Dori too good again. Three straight grade twos for Vale Dori and Mike Smith. Show Stealer not disgraced second, but again second best, then Autumn Flower and Lady Tappet.
Boy, she had all types of trouble early in the race, or pre-race. Vale Dori unseated Mike Smith when she was in the gate. And I think if you were one of the folks that had over $500,000 in the show pool for Vale Dori, you might have had a anxious moment. She comes in the gate. She wins by a length and 3/4 as the 3-10 favorite, returning $2.60. Show Stealer finishes second. Autumn Flower finishes third. That was over a wet, fast, sealed racetrack with the sunshine. 30 minutes later, the clouds had come in for the Arcadia.
Racing. What of You wins the start from Bolo and Conquest Enforcer, Ohio and Ring Weekend. What of You in front. Conquest Enforcer goes to second, Bolo third, joined by Ohio, who's racing rather keenly fourth. Last is Ring Weekend, less than 7/8 to go. And it's What of You in front by a length to Conquest Enforcer, Bolo, Ohio, and Ring Weekend a length and a half last. Sweeping around the first turn to the 6 furlongs. What of You in front by a length and a half. Conquest Enforcer running second. He's followed into the back stretch by Ohio and Bolo together. And Ring Weekend, who ultimately joined Conquest Enforcer atop the market, is last of all. They've gone off each at 6-5 in the Arcadia Stakes. Less than 5/8 from home, and What of You on a 2-week turnaround from Calcup Day is the leader by a length and a half. Conquest Enforcer running second. Bolo is third with a half mile to go, attended closely by Ohio. Bejarano bides his time, fifth and last on Ring Weekend. 5 lengths for him to pick up. At the 3/8 pole, What of You in front of Conquest Enforcer. Then Bolo making the same seasonal debut as last year. Ohio going past him on the outside. Bolo's now fourth, and still Ring Weekend is fifth and last coming to the outside. What of You taken on in earnest by Conquest Enforcer at the 3/16 pole. Conquest Enforcer confidently ridden by Pratt. What of You now ahead back on the inside, battling on gamely. Bolo recovers third. Ring Weekend is next. What of You has turned away Conquest Enforcer. Bolo's launching late on the outside. Bolo flying on the outside. He got up in the last stride to beat What of You. Conquest Enforcer, Ring Weekend, then Ohio.
And pay no attention to that teletimer, ladies and gentlemen. Boy, I'll tell you, I think I opened up Pandora's box with and they're off topic of the teletimer, but they used the hand time of 134.51, ladies and gentlemen. Forget that teletimer time. I have no idea what went wrong, but boy, when you saw the fractions up there, you just had to know 7 furlongs in 117 and change. Something was up, but Bolo scores the victory, wins the photo finish for Mike Smith at 6-1. The offspring of Temple City returns 14.60. What of You finishes second, and the 6-5 favorite Conquest Enforcer finishes third, and the 6-5 slight second choice Ring Weekend finishes fourth in the Arcadia. Sunday afternoon, three-year-olds going 7/8 in the San Vicente.
Racing. Aquamarine begins splendidly with Blabbermere, Iliad, Battle of Midway just off them. Law Biden, Citizen last. Through the opening furlong, Blabbermere a narrow leader from stablemate Iliad. Aquamarine, the inside, a close third from Battle of Midway. Law Biden, Citizen last, coming past the 5/8 pole. The leader is Blabbermere in the colours of last year's winner, Nyquist, who used this race as a springboard to Kentucky Derby glory. And it's Blabbermere on top. Law Biden, Citizen's coming right through along the inside for a share of second with Iliad, followed by Aquamarine, and Battle of Midway's actually at the tail of the field, 3.5 off the leader. Some company for Blabbermere at the 3/8 pole in the form of Law Biden Citizen, who slides along the rail for Terrio, and Iliad out 3 wide at the 5/16 pole. Blabbermere has given up the ghost. He's dropped out sharply. Aquamarine going up past him, and Battle of Midway sitting directly outside Aquamarine, 3 from the front. Iliad going nicely into the lane. Moves out by 2 lengths. Closer to 3 and upper stretch as he ducks back to the inside rail. Law Biden Citizen second, coming across his heels, trying to re-rally. Battle of Midway and Aquamarine are well back, battling for third, and it's Iliad in front for replacement jockey Flavian Pratt. Iliad scores brilliantly in the San Vicente. From Law Biden Citizen, Battle of Midway, Aquamarine fourth.
And in the new barn of Doug O'Neill, Iliad scores the victory by 3.5 impressive lengths. Flavian Pratt takes over for Rafael Bejarano, who was injured on Saturday afternoon. The second choice in the wagering returns $6, even the offspring of Ghost Zapper. Very, very sharp in victory. Law Biden Citizen finishes second. Battle of Midway, making the second career start at 4-5, finishes third. Headed east for Paris Stakes races at the Big A. Up first on Saturday afternoon, the Haynes Field.
And they're off. Repent twice from the outside. And now Fox Rules moves up to take over the lead. Fox Rules is in front. And Iron Power has moved into second. Eden Ridge is down at the rail. Then the big favorite, Send It In, and Repent Twice. Into the clubhouse turn. Fox Rules to set the pace here. In front here by almost 2 lengths, with Iron Power running in second and Send It In on the outside in third. Eden Ridge at the rail running in fourth. Repent Twice continues to trail the quarter, 24 3/5 seconds. Fox Rules in front as they head up the back stretch. The gray Iron Power in second by a neck. Send It In, the big favorite, in the clear on the outside in third. Gap of 2 to Eden Ridge and Repent Twice. Fox Rules still the leader here. It's Fox Rules in front. Ran a half in 48 4/5 seconds. Fox Rules by a length and a half. Send It In now moves into second with Iron Power back running in third. It's 3 lengths to Repent Twice and 3 more to Eden Ridge. Midway around the turn, Fox Rules in front, 3/4 of a length. Send It In drives up on the outside, gap of 2 to Iron Power in third. Fox Rules ran 3/4 in 1:12 3, and now they're in the stretch, and it is Fox Rules trying to hold off Send It In. Fox Rules leads by a length. Send It In driving on the outside. Fox Rules down at the rail. Send It In on the outside. Fox Rules and Send It In. They come down to the finish. Fox Rules, Send It In on the outside. It's going to be a photo finish. Too tight to call. Very close in the Haynes Field. The pace setter, Fox Rules, and the heavy favorite, Send It In.
Send It In. And they did in the show pool. The 1-10 favorite, actually 15 cents on the dollar, so closer to 1-7. Wins a desperate photo finish for Todd Fletcher and Manny Franco. The offspring of Big Brown returns $2.30. Fox Rules almost pulls up the big upset, finishing second. Repent Twice finishes third. Also on Saturday afternoon, the Holly Hughes.
And they're off. Busting it from the extreme outside. Lokey's Vengeance away running in second. And then it's Bon Vigilante on the outside next and third. Bust Another is fourth. Candid Desire runs in fifth. Then Celtic Chaos down at the rail in sixth. West Hills Giant is alongside. And Drama King trails the field in eighth. Busting it. has the lead here by 3/4 of a length over Bon Vigilante. The first quarter was running 22 3/5 seconds. It's 2.5 lengths. Back to Low-Key's Vengeance in third. Then another 3 to Candid Desire in fourth. Busting Others on the outside in fifth. That is West Hills Giant, Celtic Chaos. Drama King is still at the back. Busting It has the lead as the field turns into the stretch. The opening half in 45 1/5 seconds. It's Busting It in front. Low-Key's Vengeance now moving up on the outside. Celtic Chaos looking for room down at the rail. On the outside is a Candid Desire. Then comes West Hills Giant, who's in tight there. They pass the 16th pole. Here's Candid Desire down at the rail. Celtic Chaos. Candid Desire by a head. Then Celtic Chaos and Drama King came from way out of it to get third. The time was 1 minute 10 seconds.
Candid Desire for Gary Siaka and Antonio Guiardo. They win the photo finish, returning $12.80 for the offspring of Yes, It's True. Celtic Chaos finishes second. Drama King finishes third. The 5-2 favorite, Bon Vigilante, finishes last in the Holly Hughes. Well, that wraps up this week's edition of HNC. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy your stakes action from around the country and join us next time for Horses and Courses.
You're watching OTB TV, a service of Capital Off-Track Betting.